to another helpful tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be using a tool in DaVinci Resolve to clean up footage and restore a cinematic look. This tool is especially useful for footage shot under less than ideal conditions, such as with a higher ISO, resulting in grainy footage. To begin, it is recommended to correct any brightness or color issues in your footage before applying noise reduction. Create a node before this correction nodes for the noise reduction. Simply right-click, make a series node before your correction nodes. Next, click on the Motion Effects panel and select Temporal Noise Reduction. There, you will find Frame Selector option. The higher the frames, the better the result. But a powerful graphic card is required for higher frames. Choose the frames accordingly. Under the Frames option, you will find a Mode Selector. Choose from faster to better depending on your preference. The motion range section determines how much movement in your shot. Choose large, medium, or small according to your shot. In this case, we will select medium. The temporal threshold option should be set to a value of 20 to 40 for footage shot at night. Do not increase it further, or you will lose a lot of detail in your shot. In this shot, we will keep it at 26. Next, we'll go to the Spatial Noise Reduction tab, which is used to fix chromatic noise produced by different colors. Choose the faster option over better quality and keep the radius small. Under Spatial Threshold, click on the chain icon to change only the chroma part. Keep the number between 10 to 20 according to your shot and check if the chromatic noise is present or not. We are almost done. When we denoise a shot, we lose detail or definition in the video. So add a bit of sharpening to restore some of the lost details. And voila, the difference is like night and day. Even if you are not a pro, this tool is very easy to use and the results are impressive. If this tutorial was helpful to you, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next tutorial.